Our demonstration today is soldering with and without nitrogen. And the reason we at Jerry Kelly use nitrogen when we solder all of our refrigeration lines is to keep the scale and corrosion from inside the copper from the soldering process from getting into your system and possibly doing damage to it. So we're going to go ahead and start, and we'll solder the first section of tubing together without the use of nitrogen, and we'll show the effects of that, and then we'll show it with the use of nitrogen and the difference between the two. What we're doing is just soldering two pieces of copper pipe together with Dynaflow solder without the use of nitrogen, like I said. Okay, that would be basically the extent of the soldering you would need to do for a joint of that size. As it cools, you can see that the copper on the outside, the fittings and things, start to turn dark. We'll let it air cool for a little bit, and then we'll wipe it down with a wet rag. And you'll see some of that oxidation on the outside come off. But what you see on the outside of that pipe is also on the inside of that pipe. And we'll show you that in just a little bit. Cool it off with a damp rag. As you can see, just by wiping the joint on the copper pipe off with the damp rag, some of the oxidation that occurred on the outside has come off of it. But we're still going to have it on the inside. That's part of what was on the inside of that pipe left over from the soldering process. Yeah. Well, if we're trying to show a shot of down inside the pipe, even though I tapped it here, there's still a lot of scale built up on the inside of that pipe. And we'll tap it here again once it cools a little bit more and see if we can get more out of it. But that would remain in the pipe then and get into your system. The oil, the POE oil that's used with 410A Freon is a solvent-based oil. And it would wash all that out of there and keep moving it through the system, and it could potentially clog up your piston orifice or your expansion valve, causing problems with your air conditioning system. Once it cooled down, a lot more of that flaking came off of there. But it's hard to see with the camera, but there's still several large pieces down inside of it. There, more of it's coming out. So that's what happens when you don't use nitrogen. All that stays inside the tubing and actually winds up getting into the system. Okay, this time we're going to solder the same size pipe together using the same type of solder, but the only difference is we're going to introduce the dry nitrogen flow through the copper as we solder it. By doing that, it'll help reduce the scale buildup on the inside of the copper pipe, keeping your system cleaner. Soldering to allow the nitrogen to flow through for a little bit longer to help keep the scale from building up on the inside of the tubing as it cools. By using the dry nitrogen during the soldering process, there is no scale buildup on the inside of the pipe, as you can see. You can see that there's no scale buildup on the inside, and it's still bright and shiny, just as if it was new. So even if it cooled down some more, we'll tap it again, and there isn't any scale coming out of there whatsoever. That's the difference between using dry nitrogen through your system as you solder the joints and not using it. And it could save you some headaches down the road with your equipment by keeping it clean. So at Jerry Kelly, we always use a dry nitrogen process when soldering in our air conditioning systems. When you use Jerry Kelly, this is the service you'll get. If you don't use Jerry Kelly, you want to make sure the company you do use does the same process.